waiting for some theme music to come on. It ain't acting right today. But we're going to go over some things. We're going to talk a little bit of French Bulldogs. We're going to talk a little bit of this and that and the other. Hey.
What they really want from it.
True, you know what I'm saying?
What they really want from it.
Def Jam, rough, rough.
What they really want from us. Dog, I meet women, discreet women, street women, slash, cocoa puffs, sweet women, make you wanna eat women, but not me. Y'all cats eat off the plate all you want, but not deep. I get trapped these chickens from a distance. The instant they start to catch feelings, I start to steal and they quick, then I'm
what's
out
up,
just like
saying?
A thief in the night. I sink my teeth in the bite. You think your life, I'm thinking more like, what's up tonight? Come on, ma, you know I got a wife. Even though that c- tight, I ain't gonna jeopardize my life. So what is it you want? What? I gave you, you gave me. I blaze you, you blaze me.
Jump in.
Nothing less. But you at my door, willing to confess that it's the best you ever tested.
What's up, Terrence?
I'm like, all right, girlfriend.
Katrina, I knew you would feel
what
that.
You gave me, boo.
Jesse, what's up?
Let me know. Linda, Felicia, Dawn, LaShawn, Inez, and Delicia.
GB, thanks for the beanie.
Sharon, Nikki, Lisa, Mariah, Karen, Lady, Cookies. Oh, I met her in the ice cream parlor. Tanya, Diane, Laureen, Carla, Marina, Selena, Katrina, Sabrina. About three kids, LaToya, and Tina. Oh. Shelly, Bridget, Kathy, Rashida, Kelly, Nicole. Juanita,
I know a girl Tracy, by the name, Rhonda, every name you said.
Donna, Yolanda, Tawana, and Wanda. From all trees daily, but yet still.
What's up, Robert?
Up a tip, and then I'm getting that true hair. But I'ma keep it real. What the f*** you want from a girl? What the f*** you want from a girl?
What they really want from a
somebody let me know.
All right, Hart, what's going on?
What they want from a
Katrina! We got you in the song. What's up, Steph? Love you.
I think about when a dog didn't have, and a dog told a joke, and the chicken didn't laugh. See, now I do the math.
This is a clean version.
Got this,
and
this
Shalina, what's going on?
That dog, and that's all that gets me. But see, these chickens don't know. If these chickens ain't for real, these chickens don't go.
I'm running that gator blood.
Trying to creep with your best friend.
Y'all stop talking about my brown.
Oh, I know it's so hard to be.
I'm gonna let it run for one more month.
Heard you calling me names. All right.
Blue nose gay.
One thing you gotta know, I'ma be a player for life.
It's a beautiful thing. It is a beautiful thing. Rest in peace to the one, DMX. Man, X used to have me going, man. College days. I'm telling you, if you ever wanted to just feel like you could run through a wall, stone cold, knock a motherfucker clean out, I put on DMX and you couldn't tell me shit. You know what I mean? DMX is probably one of the reasons I got have had several concussions. Get to thinking you can do it all, man. Minus 32, Shalina. Good Lord. Good Lord. Good Lord. I don't even want to think about that. When I went back to Ohio one time, it was negative 43 and everything. My part of my soul came out. Yeah, X, a lot of people don't know, you know what I'm saying? Like my sister Steph was saying, he get us riled up. But yeah, X was a true dog, man. Like X didn't just have pit bulls. He had a mastiff, think that was I think he had an English Mastiff. You know, he had several dogs, you know. One of the realest things that he ever said, I don't know if y'all seen that when he said that, but he said, you know, what he loved so much about dogs is that, you know, a dog was always a dog, you know what I mean? People change, but no matter what, that dog was gonna be a dog, you know what I mean? And the dog was gonna love you, you know, regardless. It wasn't, you know, it wasn't no different, you know? And X said a lot of heavy, heavy, heavy shit, you know, but that's one thing that I always come to find out, man. You know, people might turn on you, you know, all kind of shit might happen, but that dog gonna be a dog, man. A dog, my dogs look at me like I'm crazy all the time, especially if they get to tripping. And I don't know, my dog's been on this 3 o'clock thing lately. You said, what bloodline? It was all kind of dogs put into the American Bully, man. A lot of the dogs were like the Sierra Gaff dogs, you know, you had. I mean, you name it, it's probably in the American Bully, just to be real with you, you know. Because the American Bully was very, very, absolutely, your dog will love you no matter what. The American Bully, you know, and that's something that I wanted to say is that the American Bully started in so many different directions. And one of the biggest myths is that, you know, any one person started the American Bully. The American Bully, now y'all excuse me as I'm talking and looking down at the screen, I'm actually going to share this, is that the American Bully was its own entity that was pretty much just organized by us, you know what I mean? The American Bully, you had the Gray Line, Gotti Line folks out on the West Coast. You had some boys down, you know, in the old dirty South over in Texas that had some dogs that was off of multiple lines and multiple places, and you know what I mean? Edge was on the East Coast. You know, you went down to Florida, and a lot of those dogs down there come from like the Gray Fox dogs and stuff like that, hit with some of the Edge dogs, you know. Then like Steph said, you had some Watchdog. You had a lot of stuff added, and it just Camelot dogs, you know, those dogs had Doge Bordeaux in there, and I always mispronounce that, but y'all know what I'm saying, Doge de Bordeaux. But you know, this is the thing that I want to get past, you know, in our community. And one of the reasons why I understand that even, you know, I'm attributed sometimes with being one of the pioneers of the American Bully world, you know. And I want to give a shout out to my man GP Bulls, Grounded Phoenix. If y'all not following him on IG and Instagram, y'all check my guy out. He got a lot of positive messages, and I told y'all that before. But this is his beanie that he sent me, man. Real good brother, a Bully guy. But he addresses addictions of all sorts on his podcast. Brother doing his thing, so check him out, man. But the American Bully, let me just tell y'all, it's not what it is. And this is why I think it's almost like a reset button, because one of the biggest problems you have, and you will always have this, is when one person or one specific person, I mean group of people, want to take credit for something that was really the workings of hundreds of people, maybe even thousands of people. And I want to say that I'm not going to sit here and tell you that any one person ever started, you know, the American Bully. And the contributions of the American, I mean, and there's a great amount of people, you know what I mean? That, thank you, Katrina. Yeah, please hit like, y'all. Please hit like, so they'll keep it in the, they'll keep it in the rotation, like I told y'all. As always, if y'all want to Marlena, I'll be putting that up, and I have some videos for you and everybody else in the program that I'm hoping to get done tonight with my super slow internet. I've got my hotspot, so hopefully that helps out. But I'll be posting that up tonight. Nate is doing his little editing, and when he edits, he does nothing but put his brand on there, the Bully Broadcast, and a couple other things to make it look better. So Yeah, he's not taking anybody's voices out or any messages or anything like that. I don't want y'all to think it's anything like that. But, you know, I wasn't going to talk a lot on American Bully today, but I will tell y'all this. And as y'all know, I can be somewhat religious, spiritual, and all these things in, you know, many different ways. And, man, I tell y'all, it's funny how God works. And let's get this part out of the way. It's funny how God works, you know. Because I have no problem telling y'all, my life has been tough, you know, in recent years, you know what I mean? My life has been very, very, very tough in recent years. And anybody who's a parent know that, you know, dealing with issues of, you know, with the kids is always rough. And as I've told y'all, my mother was murdered when I was very young, and I always suffered from different types of depression or whatever, so stress at times would do it. But I feel great now. And I think the last 4 years, and I just want to tell y'all this because I think it's a message and everything for everybody, you know? But the last 4 years have been the greatest test of all, and it's been the greatest conditioning of all. You know, and like I told y'all, maybe in a more angry tone, because I was a little worked up over the last couple of weeks. Not even angry, but y'all know what I mean. But like to see people talk about, you know what I mean, that I'm going to destroy you. You know, to see people think that they can make up things. Think that they can spread whatever they want to spread over the internet. And that will destroy you. Once upon a time, I thought that that was like a horrible thing, but now I find it comical. And over the last couple of weeks, I had a chance to sit back and I really, really liked, you know, Bully Scientist, I just think it's a, you know what I mean? It's a total complete road, you know what I mean? You're conditioned. It's like, Miss Estevez, I don't know if my text went through. I'm going to call you tomorrow night. Everybody said my texts weren't going through when I was at the house. No surprise. But I'll be on the road tomorrow, so that's to be our best time to talk. I know y'all got the 6-hour difference. So we can talk for hours because I'll be up driving and sipping a lot of coffee and shit. But, you know, it's like, I compare it to weightlifting, you know? And I remember I used to always yell at people this when I was training them. The weights aren't really your friend, you know what I mean? Although the weights are helping you, you know what I mean? It's like life, you know? The most weight I've ever put on a bar was 365 pounds to bench press. You know, that shit wasn't trying to be my friend. That shit was trying to crush me, you know what I mean? But throughout years and years of conditioning and years of pushing, I was strong enough to lift that weight, you know what I mean? And at that time, I can't do no 565 pounds now. I'm pretty sure I can still do 500, but I'm scared to tear a pec, so it is what it is. And right on, Steph, right on, Steph. But, you know, I was sitting there, and you shut up, boo, with this damn go blue. I love you, brother. We have to oftentimes think of this because we cry when we're going through some things. You know what I mean? We cry when our life is getting hard. You know what I mean? We start to feel sorry for ourselves when our lives is getting hard. We start to feel like that, you know what I mean? We're in this bad place. Why me? Why this? Why that? And you miss the biggest part of this. You miss the biggest part of this, that when everything is coming down on you, somehow God has built a certain strength in you that you can handle it. You may not be succeeding the way that you want to succeed. You may not be living the way that you want to live. Your relationships may not be exactly where you want them to be, but you still here. You still in the game. You're still, what's going on, Justice? You're still fighting. You still, so sometimes we get to thinking like that our lives are so screwed up, but you don't understand. You still in the game. And I was actually in the hot tub, you know, after one of these terrible workouts. And I was listening to the good Reverend T.D. Jakes, and I felt like that the message was right there, because he said when we, you know, his message was when I'm about to get into something serious, he said, I don't want the person that comes to me and tells me, you know, I've always won, I've always done it right. He said, I don't want the person that tells me, you know what I mean, that this is, you know, we gonna get through this very easy. He said, I want that person to tell me I've been through some things. I've been kicked down, I've been knocked down, I fell down, I felt broken, but here I am to fight with you again. Because sometimes when you go through things, those are the people that you want. You want people who have been broken. You want people who have put it all back together and come back fighting. You want people who have, like a diamond, you know, suffered through all this great pressure, you know? And that's the only way you can make a diamond. And just like that, you know, and just like the code that later on turns to the diamond, it's made through pressure, it's made through heat, you know? And at the very end of all of that pressure, the way that we really, really acknowledge the diamond is now is you got to be cut. So I got to be heated up, I got to be pressured, and I got to be cut just to get to the point to where people are really gonna appreciate everything that I've been through and shine on these fools. This is your life, you know? Don't feel sorry for yourself. Some of you have went through some traumatic things. We lose people. Some of you may have went through a different assaults and tragedies in life. You know what I mean? Some of you right now at this holiday season are definitely missing some people. I'm missing some people. But you in the game, baby. You know what I mean? God has you here because you in the game. God has something for you. Stop thinking about everything and worrying about things that no longer exist. And I don't mean that in a harsh way, but our worries are things that don't exist. You're worried about what could happen tomorrow. Tomorrow doesn't exist. You're worried about what happened 10 years ago. You're still struggling with your loss from a year ago, and you're worried about that. But last year doesn't exist. 10 years ago doesn't exist. What could happen doesn't exist. In this moment right now, there is no need to worry, because God has brought you here to enjoy and to fulfill. Stop worrying. Everything that you have been through, whether it was prison, whether it was death, whether it's sickness, whether you are conditioned to succeed. The person who should be scared is the person who can say, I've never been through anything. You should be scared as fuck. Y'all, excuse me, but you should be scared. If you ain't never been through some things, you should be frightened, because you don't know if you can make it. But to all of us who have fallen and gotten down, to all of us who have had our hearts broken and ripped out and got back up and start living again, understand that you are conditioned to live this life to your fullest. Stop being scared. Take that conditioning and move forward. Nobody can break you. Nobody's words can break you. Nobody, they could pray to God. like the guy in Django said, please, what's his name? Y'all know who I'm talking, Stephen. When he says, please, sweet baby Jesus, let me kill these niggas. They can pray to God that they can hurt you. And God will turn them away politely and say, that's my child. And I've conditioned him, or I've conditioned her for success. And I have a plan for him or her. But you always remember that no matter what God's plan is, the only thing that we are really, truly, truly responsible to do is to believe. To believe, to understand that we will go through things and God will pull us through it, but we've got to keep on pushing forward. And I'm just reaching out to y'all to tell y'all this, because it was a message that was delivered to me. And it's real, you know? Many of us have lost people, and you think about the people that you've lost and what they would say in your ear, you know what I mean? It wouldn't be to tell you to feel sorry for yourself. They would probably be telling you to go get it. You're still there. Go get it. Oh, definitely. Bob Marley is one of my go-tos. No woman, no cry. I also like, for whatever reason, I love Johnny is a Good Man. I don't know why. That's my thing, you know, but yeah, music. But you know, we're fighters, man. And I just want y'all to, I always tell y'all about this depression thing this time of the year. I always tell y'all how we, you know what I mean? We beat ourselves up over things that we can't control. But man, live in the moment. You got a spouse that loves you. You know what I mean? Even though they might get on your nerves sometimes, you got kids that love you, even though they definitely gonna get on your nerves at times. Enjoy the moment, because that's what life is about. You can worry your whole entire life away, your whole entire existence. You can worry as the days go by. Take this time to love the people who are here with you and embrace God's blessings that are all around you. So many times our eyes are focused on what someone is trying to do to us and what we feel like life is trying to do to us, that we forget we got blessings in front of us. We wake up to people who love us. We can reach out to people who love us. You know what I mean? That's a real thing, and that's what I had to tell y'all, you know. And I'm gonna finish this and go back to dogs. But I woke up this morning, right? And this was still on my mind, right? And I'm gonna tell you, I'm horrible with checking messages because I run all day long. I'll give y'all an example of my schedule. You know, you get up, it's dogs, Dooney, baby, babies, kids. I gotta talk to my older kids. Like literally, I literally talk to my older kids basically every day. Well, my son, you know, I talk to him every day. Max and Poop, they call about 6:30. This is my day. This is how we jump off. You know what I mean? Then you got to feed the dogs, clean the dogs, this, that, and the other. Then it's usually my trip to Walmart to grab some chicken, grab whatever supplies for the day. 3 days a week now, I'm getting in a pattern of doing this. I have to go to the gym right after this, which is a leg day. After I leave leg day, I got to pick up lunch for the kids. They get their lunch. We go to the first jiu-jitsu class. Then it's a Muay Thai class. Then it's the second jiu-jitsu class. Then it's come home and it's do all this shit all over again. So that's how my days go. So if y'all wonder, but I actually took some time to look through some messages earlier, and it was amazing because it was God. You know, I played around, and I love that song, by the way. God is trying to tell you something. It always get me. You know, I watch The Color Purple and I be wanting to stab old mister. And and when that part come, it just, you know, it always uplift you, you know. Yeah, I live in Walmart. But I was looking through the messages, and so many people had messaged me, and they was like, bro, you know, I got so many bro, and hey, T, I really respect you for fighting for this breed, you know what I mean? And several people was like, man, I see through the lies that people are saying, you know. I think the interview with Bashar really helped out, because a lot of people was like, man, this dude is obviously lying. He tells a lot of lies. We're starting to figure this out. And it was a great thing, because, you know, I think people recognized my mission more, where I was just constantly pounding about the health of the dogs. Like I told you, you don't ever have to buy a dog from me. You know, some of y'all won't be able to buy a dog from me, because I'll probably turn you down, you know, in certain situations. You know, you have to qualify to get a dog from me. I don't just, hey, anybody buy my dog. That's why I've kept Blue so long. I've literally turned down a couple dozen people to get Blue. But I saw all of this support, right? Who did the interview? Bully Broadcast did the interview. I saw all of this support, and I saw people understanding the things. And then I saw the flip side of it. And these individuals who said that they were out to destroy me start talking about losing 40,000 in sales. I don't even want to talk about how much money I've lost. People going on their lives now and like, why aren't y'all talking about y'all dogs and then the fact that they can't breathe? Why are you not talking about these dogs that died? Why are you not talking about this? See how God works? Then I went to the analytics of my pages, and good Lord, I come to find out, and this is the craziest thing ever. Now, my pages always do good numbers, right? Always do good numbers. This one does good numbers. You'd be surprised the activity rate of this page, considering there's only like, I think, was it a little over 12,000 subscribers. But this page does a ton of, it's amazing, the numbers it does. But my actual Hall of Fame page is moving towards 100 people, not clicks. I mean, excuse me, 1 million people, not clicks, but 1 million people. My percentages were up over 500%. So before it would get like closer to like maybe a closer to 250,000 people, now it's right there at 1 million people. And it wasn't even at 250,000 people, you know, and the inbox is flooded. It's like their hate blessed me. More and more people, you know what I mean? No, I'll end up putting the interview up. He's downloading it and doing some things. I'll put it up on this page. I promise y'all that. It'll be up today. Nate told me he would get over today. But they blessed me. All the numbers went up. More and more people are talking about what do we have to do with healthy dogs. You know what I mean? You preaching the right message. How do we get rid of these people? Their hate turned into all I ever cared about was a healthy dog movement and doing things the right way. I thank you, brothers, you know. I thank you. I thank the community who is smart enough to look up and say, you know what? What's going on, Karan? It was smart enough. Yeah, that was Tafiti. She live in a whelping box. She's weird. But, man, I appreciate it, MOB. You know, but it's great, man, because like I told y'all, I don't even so much care about selling dogs. I just want this community to clean up and stop doing the things that they're doing. Stop flooding these rescues. Stop flooding, you know what I'm saying? Stop getting us to the point to where veterinarians don't want to deal with us. Stop, you know, doing things that's going to allow it easier for legislation, you know. The French Bulldog, let's go. Now, as many of you know, not just seeing French Bulldog, so as many of you know, good Lord, yeah, the mass over confirmation. And Steph could tell y'all a lot. Steph, as a judge, the three things that I can tell you that Steph could definitely tell you about is Bulldogs, French Bulldogs, and I'm not excluding her as an American bully person, but she knows Doberman. She grew up with Dobermans. Her father raised Dobermans, so... Steph could give y'all a lot of information on those breeds. But our community is doing something that's horrible. And I won't excuse it. And this is one of the breeds that we have. You know what I mean? What's going on the real? Hey, they hate to see us vibing, man. But they hate, you know. But I tell you, the French Bulldog is not supposed to be what a lot of people are doing to it. The giant rope thing is not supposed to be. I'm gonna tell y'all this, and some people don't know, and y'all don't think that I'm talking to y'all like peons or something, because I understand a lot of people here have this knowledge. You know what I mean? The French Bulldog generally, you know what I mean, should be a well-breathing dog. The French Bulldog should not have an afro or look like Kendrick Perkins' beard. The pink French Bulldog is not a pink French, is not a French Bulldog. The fluffy French Bulldog has actually been around for a very, very long time. But what people are doing now and saying it's the fluffy is not the fluffy French Bulldog. The actual fluffy, there was some people who made that a long time ago. And what we're seeing now is not that. You know what I mean? It's now, Steph, I don't know what the hell, man. It's nowadays, the French Bulldog has went the way of the American Bully. And it has become a designer breed. And I think we have to be very, 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 very careful. You know what I mean? Well, yeah, Steph, I would love... Matter of fact, if you get a chance, send me that video of your boy on that rope. I would like to post that. But, you know, now, one thing, you know, I do know a lot of the AKC breeders, the real breeders of French Bulldogs, won't even give you rights to their dogs anymore. Like, you can just get a pet, or that's it, because of some of the issues. A lot of those breeders, is like Steph said, if the dog has a breathing issue, it is considered a pet. Yes, you'll do the surgery to fix it, but they won't allow this to be rebred.